less than 2 months away, excuse me, for the general elections, an exercise that sets political parties splurging on advertisements and branding. And while the entire exercise may or may not win them votes, media companies certainly don't complain. A large chunk of the money, after all. One such player, which has a sizable presence in the India heartland, is the Dainik Bhaskar Group. So let's get in Girish Agarwal, non-executive director of DB Corp, to talk about this, as well as newsprint prices, which have seemingly come off. Girish, good having you. Thanks for joining in. Conversations in the analyst community and the investor community are full of how the run-up to the elections can show a strong uptick in volumes and value for media companies. Can this uptick happen in the run-up to the elections, or is the street too hopeful?
So, okay, let me classify this whole run-up to the election in two buckets. One is the political advertising and the government advertising. And second is the general advertising from the industry player on automobiles, on consumer durables, etc. So the amount of advertising which comes from the political parties or the government missionaries is very limited. It's not much. And it gets offset by the code of conduct coming into the picture where the regular advertising goes down. But because of the overall spend in the market by the government, whether it's on the infrastructure and all, the other categories like automobile and consumer durables, they start seeing some kind of buoyancy in their sales. And then they start advertising in the newspapers or television media or whatever, all that. So overall, we do get benefited by that.
Okay. So higher ad rates, and they seemingly have moved up for you in the last quarter to 13%, if they continue or if they improve. And post the election spend, IPL, World Cup, would all of these come together in a sweet spot for you in quarter one FY20?
So this 25% growth by the government on the advertising rates certainly is going to help the industry, not only in this quarter, but the years to come, because this rate revision happens once in 3 years time with the government, and it is the most welcome thing. In fact, it should be done every second year considering the inflation which is already happening. So that's one good point. Second thing, because of the overall environment becoming positive, the advantage of the advertising comes to us. And on top of it, the summer season, education season, and the World Cup also coming in, and IPL also coming in. So all that does look forward. We all are looking forward to have a very, very positive impact. I would say as of now, we are sitting at a strong single digit advertising growth. With all this, we should be touching the double digit growth also in the coming quarter.
Interesting you say double digit. We already had a 13% ad growth in the quarter gone by. Can ad growth rate be higher than 13% then?
We are all working towards it. The quarter three was strong because of the Diwali festival in that quarter. So Q4 should be slightly lower than that. But we are hopeful that Q1 of the next year will be almost touching that number.
Okay. What about the circulation revenue growth? It dipped marginally in quarter three, I think was about 3 or 4 odd percent. Can it pick up?
Next year, we'll have to take a call that do we want to take a cover price increase? Because the growth in the circulation revenue comes from twofold. One is the overall circulation growth, and second is the cover price increase. So circulation growth impact of those 3-4% will still be there. But if we take a cover price growth, then another 5-7% can come from there. But that call, we're yet to take that call.
Girish, the other big talking point is about newsprint prices cooling off. What's your sense out there? Are the benefits material?
Yes, very material impact, because the newsprint prices are now have come down from the in the US dollar terms to roughly around 520, 530 US dollar. So I think that's a very, very positive impact. From coming down from almost $750, $800 to $730 is a big relief. So I think next year there'll be a big impact of that in the profitability.
Okay, so would the benefits of this lower cost come in newsprint, come in quarter four itself, or would you only see that come in the next year?
No. Why? Because quarter four, all the consumption what we are doing is of the material which was bought in Q2 and Q3. So the actual impact will start coming from Q1, and Q2 will have the total impact.
Okay, so Q2 FY20 would see the total impact of these lower newsprint costs. Fair enough. Let's talk about the other businesses, Girish. How is the radio business shaping up for you?
So I think the radio will continue to grow in the same line, because their expenses are taken care of already. The new stations which we launched, they all are becoming EBITDA positive. Already most of them have become EBITDA positive. So I think radio is shaping up pretty well. Good thing about radio is that there's no cost jump like newsprint in the print business. So their cost is largely steady, and whatever money, if they are able to get more from the market in terms of advertising growth, that's a straightaway positive to their EBITDA. In the digital, as we mentioned to you a couple of quarters back, that we are now focusing on that we should be profitable from our platform itself rather than feeding the money onto the social media platform. So we have been very successful in that. And there's a number you see, and going forward, we believe the digital business will show some more profit.
Okay. What about the digital business? How are the revenues shaping up there?
So what we did, we realized in last 2-3 years time, we were, and all of us were, spending money on the social media to get the traffic over there. You know, last year we took a call that we don't want to spend money to get the traffic from the social platform. So over there now we are kind of cost neutral. We post our news on the social media, on the Facebook and all that platforms, to the extent where it takes care of the cost by themselves. So we are no more in that rut of getting more eyeballs in the platforms and, you know, kind of converting them, naming them as your traffic, you know, because what happens when a person comes to a particular platform, he or she sees the news of mine on that platform and he's not able to come to my website from that. So he said, there's no point feeding that kind of consumer. So we are developing more on our app and our own platform where we that want people to come on to DainikBhaskar.com or DivyaBhaskar.com, and we are, you know, able to engage the customer over there, the reader over there. This has been able to help us to save the cost and to increase the revenue directly onto our platform. And that's going to be focused going forward also.
Okay. Have you been able to hike rates for digital offerings? And if you've indeed moved companies or viewers to your platform versus social media platforms, have the lower eyeballs on the social media platforms impacted your ad run rates?
Yeah. So what we did, we lost eyeballs on the social media platform and we lost the revenue on the social media platform. But at the same time, my cost on the social media came down drastically. So I'm a cash neutral in that kind of scenario over there. But on our website, where the traffic increased, and we were able to monetize that better.
Speaking to some of your peers, Girish, and they were saying that the radio business is no longer remain only a radio business. It will be a lot more than radio, bit of consulting, bit of job work, etc. What's the experience at DB Corp? How is the radio business doing that way?
So in what's happening in radio business, I think a large portion, maybe 20-30%, depending on the station to station, come from the non-FCT genre, which means we become an agency, an event manager, or a ground operator for a particular client, and we deliver the eyeballs to them, response to them by doing the ground events, linking up to the print, linking it up to the radio and everything and everything. So I guess that's the model which industry has evolved.
That model lead to ad rates or revenues going slower than what was the case earlier?
I would see it this way, that a large chunk, maybe higher percentage, started coming from the other activities, but the rates of the radio will not go down. In fact, it will go up only, because then I'm not under pressure to sell my inventory at whatever price, because I'm anyway making money from somewhere else. So I will add the premiumness onto my spots on the radio, and I'll offer some kind of benefit on ground to the advertiser.
Okay. So then my final question, if you're indeed so optimistic on all the three verticals, can you give us some sense of the CAGR growth rates for your business for the year ahead?
See, frankly speaking, we don't do forward forecasting because we don't believe in the crystal gazing. I can give you any number on an Excel sheet. But frankly speaking, the looking at the overall environment, we have to look at every quarter. So I'm right now very bullish, very positive about the Q1 and Q2 coming forward.
Okay, Girish, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for taking the time out and being with us, and all the best for the quarters ahead. That's DB Corp saying that the material impact of the cool off in newsprint prices will only come in Q2 because the newsprint for the current quarter and maybe even part for the next quarter have already been, the rates have already been locked in.